friends, welcome to day three, the final day of inward and outward freedom. Y'all, I am so excited. We have been on this journey of finding complete freedom. It has been so powerful, but we are going to go ahead and end out with today. And I'm going to leave you out, guys, with a lot of scripture to continue to study and just pray through. So let's go ahead and hop into today's video. Today is this. The Lord spoke this to me, and I'm going to read it to you guys, and then I'm going to go ahead and just kind of go through a couple of scriptures that have altered my life, and I want you guys to just read and dwell over in the next couple of days and for the rest of your life. Here's what the word of the Lord was to me. The problem with your generation is that they have lost the hunger to see me, to know me, and to hear from me. They want to know me as healer and deliverer, but not as father, friend, and teacher. They need the awe of God and the fear of the Lord. And so whenever the Lord said that to me, something in my soul was grieved because I realized how true that was. And how I watched a prayer room. There was a prayer room that I like follow and I listen to some of their stuff. And in one of their videos, they were saying, when is the last time that we went into prayer and asked God, I just want to see you. I just want to hear from you. Not for any personal gain. I just want to know you more. And I think that grieves God's heart, that we always ask, God, come heal me. God, come deliver me. God, come bless me. God, come give me a lot of Instagram followers or Facebook followers. Come bless me, bless me, bless me, bless me. But we never ask, I'm your son, I'm your daughter, I just want to see you, God. Like, I just want to feel your presence. I just want to be with you forever and ever. And I think about David in the Bible, how David just, if you read through the Psalms, which was written by David, if you read through these Psalms, a lot of his Psalms were him repenting and saying, God, I can't bear to go a day without being with you. God, I just want to be near you. I mean, you read through the Psalms and you just see this incredible hunger, holy, desperate desire for God. And I mean, even it's Sunday whenever I'm filming these, but this Sunday morning before church started, I sat and just read through some Psalms that I really enjoy. And every time I read Psalms, I just feel this desperation, this cry unto God that's just, God, I need you. I don't want you to come and bless me. I just want to know you. And it frightens me that a lot of people don't seek him unless they know they're going to get something to bless them. Being with God, he blesses his children. And that's powerful. That is our God. He loves us so much. He blesses us. I mean, oh my gosh, if people think that God doesn't love them, read the Bible. Do you not realize that God sent his one son to die for you? And then whenever Jesus goes back up into heaven, what is he doing? Interceding for us, praying for us. What a God. I mean, goodness, that is incredible. That is one of the greatest forms of love ever. That is the form, that God is love completely. I just did a video series about that, actually, about the love of God a little bit ago. Also on my YouTube channel, if you want to know more about the love of God. Anyways, we have to get back to seeking God. It is our only connection to heaven on this earth. Until we get to heaven, how we can see heaven, encounter heaven, and feel heaven is by seeking God. Jesus actually says that he draws all men unto himself. And so, I just want to challenge you in this question. Do you truly want to know God? Or do you want to know him just enough to get you into heaven? Think about that. And that's not meant to like offend you. Well, it kind of is. If that offended your flesh, good. You probably needed to hear it. Whenever I say that, it offends my flesh sometimes. And that's good. That means that you needed to hear that. Let that dig deep. So I had a video that I was going to show y'all, but for copyright reasons, I won't show y'all. But it's a reading of Revelation chapter 5. So the other day, I was reading through Revelations, and I was in this sanctuary because I'm in a church right now. I was in there alone reading through Revelations, and I got to Revelation chapter 5. And I am not much of a crier. I don't cry a whole lot, but I got to that and I'm not joking, wept bitterly, like on the floor, could not get up. And I was actually late to work because I had, I was late to my work because I was crying on the floor reading Revelations. And it's because in Revelations, it talks about that no one was found worthy to break the seal and open the scroll, except for who? The line of Judah. You can go read that. Absolutely let that wreck your heart. Go read Revelation chapter 5 and let it dig deep. Oh my gosh, that is the God we serve. I think that it's so powerful that John actually walked with Jesus, and John was actually the beloved one. He had his ear on Christ's chest, on Christ's chest. That is how close they were. They were best friends. They walked together. And whenever John encountered Jesus, but not, this is after Jesus ascended and back into heaven. After he died, he came back onto this earth, and then he ascended into heaven. So this is John, the beloved, encountering Jesus, but in his real heavenly form. John couldn't even speak, and he couldn't even get up because he was so in awe. And that is the God that we serve. Oh, it blows my mind, but go read Revelations. In the Bible, it also says, I encourage you after this video is done, go read Revelation chapter 5, let it dig deep. Also in the Bible, it says, seek me and you shall find me. If we are looking for any answer, every answer that you need is found in God. Whenever you seek him, you shall find him. God is not this far off man that is hard to encounter. A lot of people have asked me, Malachi, it feels so hard to connect with God. I don't get it. And it's not hard to connect with God. He actually designed it to be easy. It's our sin, and we need repentance. Whenever we are disobedient to God, it's harder to connect with him, because disobedience does not equal free time with God. No, God comes where he's welcomed. And if I'm living a lifestyle that is rejecting God over and over, I can't expect him just to come and visit me and just say, hey, what's up, best friend? Now, God is a loving God. Nothing can separate us from the love of God, but it's harder for us to hear from him whenever we're consumed with disobedience. Does that make sense? Y'all aren't going to answer because this is a recording. But anyways, I just want to say this for all the people in the back. Seeking God and encountering God is not radical. It's expected. This year right now, the day that I'm filming this, is October 1st, 2023. And I can say that in the modern church, if you seek God and encounter God, that seems radical, and it's not. It is actually expected. If you read these scriptures, you will find what being a true Christian looks like. I look at the world today, and I see Christianity, and it is nowhere near biblical Christianity, and it blows my mind and it breaks my heart. If you just read the Bible, you will understand that seeking God is actually expected, and it's not radical. It's something we should be doing. In Matthew chapter 6, verses 6, it says, when you pray, and then it goes into how to pray, but it doesn't say, if you pray, if you have a spare 5 minutes in your day, maybe you can give it to God. No, it says when you pray. As a Christian, we are expected to be in a relationship with God. How do we form a relationship? Prayer. John chapter 15, remain in me and I will also remain in you. How do you remain in God? Prayer. How do you put the presence of God? Prayer. How do you hear from God and let him sanctify you? Let me think. Oh yeah, prayer. Hello. Prayer is how we build a relationship with God. It is the foundation. Oh my gosh, I can run a lap right now. It is the foundation of Christianity. And I'm looking at a church today. Oh, I'm gonna start praying in tongues. I'm looking at a church today that has lost the art of prayer. And you think it's some secret art. No, it is something God is expecting us to do. And I would hate, absolutely hate, to get to heaven and say, God, I went to church every Sunday, and God says, depart from me, I didn't know you. Because you can walk into a church and still miss God. Hello. You know the scripture in the Bible that says, God, we cast out demons in your name, we healed the sick, and God says, depart from me, I didn't know you. There is a way that seems right to a man, but in the end leads to death. That's in the Bible. It says, there is a way that seems right to a man, but in the end leads to death. Sorry, I got really excited, full of the Holy Spirit. You may think that being a Christian means that you can only go to church on a Sunday and that's it, you're making it to heaven. Can I just be a very real voice in your life and say, that's not how you build a relationship. Think about worldly relationships. If you only met someone for 2 hours, once a week to have a date, And the whole time you were distracted and not even encountering him. You think that that's your soulmate? You think that that's who you're going to marry? No. We need God. Not just one day of the week, but every day, every minute. Remain in me and I shall also remain in you. How can you follow someone that you don't even know? It's really hard to follow God if you do not know him. How can I go from half-hearted Christianity to walking in complete inward and outward freedom? John chapter 12, verses 23. Is if you do not die to yourself, you will never produce fruit. And in John chapter 15, it also talks about that. No vine, that God is the true vine and we are the branches. If we are not connected to the vine, we can never bear fruit. Because we can never bear fruit if we're not connected to him. How are we connected to him? Prayer, building a relationship with him. Everything that we do is based on the foundation of prayer. Okay, before I encountered God, I was not the best gal in the world. I knew about God. I've gone to church my whole life. My parents are pastors. But I had not yet encountered the man of Jesus. Whenever I encountered him, everything changed. And I can stand firmly and say the girl I was 3-4 years ago, 5 years ago, 6 years ago is nowhere near where I am now. The reason I am different is because of this. Because I allow God to sanctify me. If you want to know how to truly and completely be inwardly and outwardly free, you must allow God to sanctify you and you must allow the Holy Spirit to fill you because the Holy Spirit convicts and affirms. He says, oh, don't do that. No, don't do that. My ways are better than yours. Submit to my will and I will make you righteous. That's not a scripture, I just made that up. But whenever we allow the Holy Spirit to convict us, he says, you're spending too much time on your phone. You're not spending time with God. And that can offend your flesh, but let it. Can I just say, it is sometimes okay to be offended. Whenever you're in church and the pastor says something that hits really close to home and you get that fence over you, it's okay. Let it dig deep and let it dig so deep that it says, something's gotta change. I hope this series encouraged you guys. Listen, I have tons more on my YouTube channel, which is going into more depth about finding complete and whole freedom, finding the man Jesus, and also finding who you are in God. There are so many different topics on my YouTube channel. I encourage you, stay connected. I hope this series encouraged you guys. If you like this series, comment down below and I will make a couple of more of these videos. Hopefully a lot more of these videos. Also, my last thing I'm gonna leave you with is go read Psalms chapter 63 in the Passion Translation. If you don't have a Passion Bible, go read it on your phone on the Bible app. You can switch it to TPT, the Passion Translation. I encourage you guys to go and read that. I love you all so much and I'll see you guys later. Bye.